Welcome back, guys. This is Ibrahim Quraishi here, and today we are going to cover how to upgrade a vCenter server. So VMware basically is quite prompt in recognizing any bug fixes or any issues which they see working with obviously different vendors and different partners, and they basically release security updates and bug fixes quite often. And as a VMware administrator, it's your job to make sure your environment is patched and secure, like from security point of view and also from bug fixes point of view. Recently, we have done three sessions on how to upgrade the ESX host. This is the first thing you will need to do in your environment before even upgrading the host to the next patch. So first, upgrade your vCenter server and then bring all the hosts to the same patch or baseline as your vCenter server. That is the suggested way from VMware, because if you have any issues, then VMware will say your vCenter is below the build number of your ESX host. Although it is allowed to have a higher build number on the host, but it is suggested, it is a best practice or good practice to have the vCenter server on the higher or the same base or build number with the host. Okay, so let's get started. Before we begin, I just wanted to thank you all for subscribing to my channel. Make sure you hit the notification bell and hit all so that you get all the updates, all the new videos which I'm creating. You can instantly get the updates on your phone or your email address. So let's get straight into it. So VMware vCenter patches. VMware regularly releases patches for vCenter server appliance that might be related to third-party products in the platform or core product functionality or both of them. So it could be, the patches could be related for third-party products and also even some functionality enhancement of VMware product itself. So that's why you need, and again, they are, as I said earlier, security patches are also very important and bug fixes. So this is why we need to make sure the environment is patched. So these are the steps we are going to take, and these are our agenda items. What I normally suggest is to check the compatibility with the ESX host, as I was suggesting earlier. So the host, try to make sure your vCenter is on a higher build or the same build as the host. So if you're upgrading your ESX host, make sure you upgrade your vCenter first and bring your host on the same build number or the same baseline. The baseline is the VMware update manager terminology. I'm sure you guys have picked that up from the last three videos. Okay, and also make sure you check with the compatibility with the third party. So say for example you are having a backup with Veeam or, you know, Quraishi, so you need to make sure you get to the vendor website and check whether the new updates, whether you are rolling out update 3 on 6.7, whether it is compatible with the new rollout which you want to do. Because the last thing you want is your environment, after you have patched, you realize that you can't backup your environment or you can't do a major functionality. There are other products around as well which are VMware products which you could be using, like, you know, orchestrator or, you know, something else which needs these dependencies to be checked beforehand, before you know, plan your upgrade. So that's why always make sure you check the third party website, VMware website, for compatibility. So here's how you are going to do it. We are going to log into the VMware administrator view, which is basically the administrator console, and then we are going to do some health checks. As always, I suggest you, basically before doing any upgrades, take a snapshot of your vCenter server and then we'll start updating the vCenter server. So what we are going to do here is we are going to log into the administration side of this. So we will be going to the IP address of the vCenter server or the fully qualified domain name, and then we can go :5480, which is going to be the admin console. Now over here you need to remember that you need to log in with your root credentials, which is when you set up your appliance. And bear in mind, this root credentials may expire after 45 days or 90 days. I can't remember the exact limit. But if they do so, you will not be able to log in from here. What you have to do is SSH using your root credentials to the appliance and then change your password first. Only then you will be able to log in from here. Okay, so as I was saying, first thing we will be doing is the health check. So over here, the first screen which VMware has kindly put together for us is a summary page, which basically gives you your overall health check. So your CPU is good, your memory is good, databases are looking good, storage and the swap. Also, it shows you which domain you're connected to, which is vSphere.local, and status is running, the SSO is running. Another thing you can pick up from here is shows you the version which you're using, which is 6.7, and the build number, which is 13643870. When we patch this vCenter server, when we upgrade this, update this, so you will see a different build number after that. So bear in mind. So you can check other stuff over here. I don't know whether you guys use the appliance management console before, but you can see CPU and memory graphs, disk graph, network and databases. So you can draw it across like a week or so. You won't find anything on mine because I had my lap suite off for a couple of weeks now, and today I have powered it on. Okay, so let's get started to what we want to do. So we go on the updates tab. So click on the updates tab, and then over here you'll see the current version, and again it is showing you the current version, and then over here available updates last checked on the 10th of February 2020. So the patches are regularly checked every day. If your environment allows you to talk to the internet, then basically they automatically go and talk to the internet and they get the patches. So let's wait for the updates to be gathered. Once they are updated, we can look into it. Okay, so the updates have been pulled together, and we can see that there are quite a few builds which are available here. The one which we were using are 67031, which is 67031, and then this is even higher than that. So I guess when we are upgrading it, what will happen is it's going to take us to the latest build version. So also you need to bear in mind that whichever build version we choose, it will basically roll it out to the latest, till the latest version. Okay, so we just need to select the latest version available. So I would say that will be this one, right? The December one, 5th of December, critical patches. So also there's a note, update and patches are cumulative. The most recent updates or patches in the table below will contain all previous patches. So you don't need to go and install the older version first. So if I just select the latest one, this is 6704 and this is 6702000. So this is the one which is the latest one, and according to the dates as well, this is last year, May, October, July and August. So December is the latest one. So we can select that and then click. Well, before that, as discussed, we will need to take a snapshot of the vCenter server, which we didn't take. And also I would suggest, because the vCenter will be rebooting, you have access to the host where the vCenter is running. So my vCenter is running on this particular host. So these are the prereq which we need to do. Let's launch the vCenter as well from here, and then we'll log into the host at the same time. over here, I can see my vCenter here. Right click and take a snapshot. Make sure you remove snapshot virtual memory and then say update vCenter. And then the date, which is 19 Jan, sorry, Feb 2020, and I'll put my initials to show that I have taken the snapshot. So to make it descriptive, write pre-upgrade vCenter server. Upgrade vCenter server. Yeah, take the snapshot. The snapshot is taken. Administrator at vSphere.local. So this is the vCenter which we are going to patch anyway. What we are going to do now is I haven't taken the snapshot from here, but I just wanted to check. Pre-upgrade, and it is just taken today. Well, the vCenter is having an hour ahead time. So as you can see, pre-upgrade. So the snapshot is done and we have verified it. So let's go ahead and start the updates. Let's stage only first, and we'll see how long it takes to stage. I'll pause this for the moment. Okay, so back, guys, I had to pause the video for a little while. As you can see, 6.7.0 42,000 is staged, and you can see there is two options now. First one is install or unstage. If I select a different one, it will say stage only, install only. So basically this is ready for us to install. So unstage is basically deleting the files which we have downloaded on the vCenter server. It just speeds the process up. If you stage the patches, that means they are downloaded on your vCenter server and ready for install. Once I click install, you will see this screen might get disconnected, and at the same time my vCenter here, which is running here, might get disconnected. But this is why what I have done is I have connected to the host where the vCenter server is. So always make sure you connect to the ESX host to see if there is any problems, or you can reboot it if it gets hung or something like that. Again, just to remind, the first thing we did is we took a snapshot of the vCenter server, which you can remember, and that's all ready now. A snap is taken, so now we are ready to click install. And now we just need to accept the end user agreement that we are installing it. Make sure you read all of that in your own leisure. Okay, then click next. The estimated downtime is 143 minutes. To use the file base backup, go to backups, which is right here, as you can see. But I'm not going to do that because I have taken a snapshot and I'm fairly confident it will go through. If not, I'll rebuild my vCenter server. This is just my lab. So hopefully everything should be okay. But if you are in production environment, I suggest you to have a backup of your configuration. You could do a video on how to do that later on, but for now, let's get started. So if I click finish, the upgrade will start. As you can see, the patches were already staged, so it's basically stopping all the services, and we have lost the connectivity to the admin page. It's flickering, I guess, in that sense. Stopping the services on 50%. What will be interesting to see is the monitor view and see how it is doing with CPU and memory. It's not too bad, really. What I do want to do is make sure I keep an eye here on the vCenter server to see when it gets rebooted. So everything here is still working. I believe so. So let me pause the video and we'll come back once it's nearly done. I guess so. We can see the appliance is upgraded, and you can see the current version is not 6.7.0.42,000. So there you go. You can log in. I'm just logging in the vCenter as well. See, so this is the first time you're logging in after it has been upgraded. So that's how simple it is to upgrade the vCenter. We go summary and then we can see, should come up with everything back. Overall health was checked now, everything is good, and the build number has gone up to 15132721. So there you go, guys, it's all upgraded. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and do reach out to me if you have any questions on Twitter or on Facebook, where that's where I mostly post these videos, and log in, subscribe to my blog. And question of the day today: how do you log into the administration UI? Do you remember the login, how we did? So we use USSO or do you use root? Well, root R should be lowercase, but yeah, there you go. So leave a comment below and let me know, guys, and hope you enjoyed watching this video of upgrading the vCenter server. Don't forget to subscribe and enjoy watching. Keep sharing. Cheers. Bye.